Healy would know more about these seeds once we plant them. What are you fishing for?
I'm hunting the ferocious Mee. Did you know the Mee was the very first fish we scuba caught?
That must have been quite a day.
Aye, I was barely yee-high back then. Little scuba swam headlong into the creature's mouth.
Like it caught you.
Hey, it takes me back. Stick around, boy, and I'll top us off with a tail. Aye, so we return to my time on the Grapnel. Against the protestations of my heart, I forsook the rod and line for the harpoon. For years, we trawled the outer rim, spearing every fish that happened across our path. Talented as I was, I speared more fish than the rest of the crew. Put together. Fool as I was, I didn't have the wisdom to be ashamed. The dread Captain Wanyak Wet took notice. He showered me in brevets, gave me the best of catches, and scarcely a year after I left Sakavi Tar, I became his first meat. Shortly after my promotion, we were on our way to Manan to sell the carcass of a gooberfish, but wham! Just as we dove out of hyperspace and the great ocean world streaked into view, so did she. The most glorious creature I'd ever beheld. A whale of marvelous proportion. But swimming through Manan's orbit like it was nothing but an easterly current back home. I was transfixed.
No kidding. How close did you get?
Funny you should ask. I didn't have long to set my eyes abulge before we crashed headlong into her. The grapnel bounced off her like chum off flotsam. We plummeted down to the ocean, sundering the grapnel on the sea floor, where a gang of pirate quarren were holed up. The filthy Zephyrs. We swam out of the ribbon hull and found ourselves surrounded by quarren, demanded all manner of things, including our bounty of fish. So, away we swam, Captain Wet, the crew, and myself. But, blind as we were at such depth, we shortly ran into a dead end, finding ourselves surrounded by quarren. Find me again, and I'll continue the tale.
Back to it. Tolo recommended we check this chamber out. Thank you.
Welcome, Jedi. Our problems are often matters of perspective. By shifting our position, so too moves our thinking, and thus by reframing it, a problem may not seem so vexing after all.
Sounds familiar.
I heard Dagon boarded the first transport out.
Nonsense. He would never.
Wherever he is, we need him. This is not good.
This planet is so different to Coruscant.
I find its quiet almost deafening by comparison.
And yet, there's a unique peace to it.
Show this to Z. Off we go.
Sector. Wait, what's that? Looks like it's from the clone. It's incoming!
Not much to look at. Let's see if Doma's interested in this. This is crawling with Imperials. Just gotta keep climbing. Interesting. The Empire's really cracking down around here. How long before they set their sights on the outpost? Visibility's pretty bad. Gotta push through. Let's stop here. energy conduit. You don't have anything for it, do you? Is that an Imperial shuttle? Don't know why they were flying in such poor conditions. Want to check it out? The lift isn't here.
Now there's an unusual sight.
You with the Raiders?
Raiders? No, no. We're no foe to you, nor friend to them.
What's up ahead?
Mist and more mist. And all manner of danger prowling within. Watch your feet, unless the mountain have them for its own.
We'll keep that in mind. Let's take this to Doma's. Must have been thriving here once. Now it's a ghost town. Keep your sensors running, BD. I don't trust this place. was off. Good job, BD.
I guess the platform is somewhere else. We should take these seeds back to the garden. A shard. Let's trade it at Doma's shop. Seems we gotta climb the rest of the way. Safer than going on foot. Security, huh? Wonder who was trying to keep things hidden.
sent to secure a shuttle. Must be something inside.
Dart? Next time, maybe run a scan before you start firing. Okay, I'm ready.
doesn't look happy. Prospectors move out, and the beasts move in. Hard place to call home.
If I can do this. No. I have to.
That new gadget's pretty useful, huh? Something's up there. Hey, this is a good find. On you, BD.
Okay, I'll look.
As a result.
So if we're attacked, get up nice and close.
Your logic is sound.
Is with me. Back to it. That's a lot of firepower. Hit it. Let's take the high ground.
I am very aware that the magnetic seals are engaged. Remaining fight is accounted for.
Trooper, you're late.
It's not my fault. I just returned from patrol.
Why did your patrol take so long?
Bramlicks.
Bramlicks?
Local wildlife. Orbs with spikes.
Let me get this straight. You were held up by a rolling ball with spikes?
There was also the fog.
I don't have time for this. Report your blaster for inspection.
Fine.
I see him, BD. That's the last of them.
Right there. I won't let you through. I saw what you did to the others, Jedi scum. But you won't do it to me. Even your sorcery can't get through 15 centimeters of Imperial manufactured transparent steel. Right?
Structural.
You should open the door.
I should... What?
This is an inspection. You have orders to let me pass. Let's hope so. Weak minds don't stop them from conquering the galaxy. Let's head out. Need to open this. Okay, this is high. Long way down, huh? Hell of a view, though. Launch it. shard. Let's trade it at Doma's shop. BD-1, over here.
Oh, what a view. You'd have liked it, Shanna.
What?
Lad, I'm always on edge when fishing for the finger-lipped Garpon.
What a name.
And fierce as they come. But that doesn't deter the poachers. The poor Garpon, despite its rarity, is a delicacy for the black of heart and the rumbly of belly. In we go! That beauty. Two plump fins. A fine complement of glands. A scrumptious varicose tongue.
Fishing on an empty stomach, Scuva?
Hey, I can't succumb to the passions of the stomach. The Garpon must live. I'd better get me mind off it. Then spin your tail.
So, Scuva, whatever happened with the pirates?
So there we were. Four Quarren, armed with spears, each way of mine to make a mantelpiece of my wee rubbery head. I looked over to me captain, and he stared right back, waving his arms like a goober fish in heat. At the harpoon I held in my hand. Oh, for a black instant, I considered nailing those pirate Quarren to the rocks with my harpoon. But something stopped me from pulling the trigger. Perhaps it was the sparkle that caught my eye. The sparkle of a passing Glumbrigeel. What would those pirates say to a whole school of Glumbrigeels? A crackle and a sparkle as they be, thought I. So I opened my wee mouth and emitted the mating call of the eel.
You speak eel?
Aye. But I forgot to turn on me comb. We Scriven alone heard the cry. The bad, demented expression put such a fright on the Quarren that it dropped the blasters. By the time they'd come to the senses, we were swimming away as fast as our flippers could carry us. was only later, as we fled aboard the Zephyr schooner, that I realized how close the real danger was. But I shall continue the tale next time.
Let's stop for a moment. Let's move, BD. Not bad. I've seen worse rooftop gardens.
I see you found new seeds. Plant one, and I'll tell you all about it.
To the left.
I was hoping you'd find seeds like that. Put one in the ground. I'll share what I've learned.
Thanks for the help. We can trade this at Doma's shop. What's that? Let's take this to Doma's. Let's take this to Doma's. Let's take this to Doma's.
Out of here. First thing is paid a visit to Doma Dendra. You hear that? Oh no!
Run! Go!
Something here. Looks like it's still here.
Breathe.
It's quaint.
Another bounty pug. We should show this to Cage.
Oh.
Okay, no funny business. Just put the scrap down and your hands up. This area is under the control of the Bedlam Raiders.
Funny folk, ain't ya? This is a lot of pretty interesting tech you have here. Why, but you're not supposed to be here.
Appreciate it.
To no bibi.
Let's see if Doma's interested in this. Easy, Neko.
raiders. They're trying to destroy the camp.
I'll show you why I was promoted. Is this what we do? You, get up here and attack! Watch a real droid shoot!
Where's the fighting running? Surprise!
Beware ricochets!
Well, villages can live in one of these crawlers. Traveling across planets as a single unit. This one doesn't look like it's moving a lot. Check it out, BD. Priorite. Are you all okay? Not sure what that means, but... you all look safe. If you need any supplies, you should stop by the Rambler's Reach outpost.
Ah, what's Poobo?
Yeah. See you around.
Jawas seem pleased, huh? Maybe they're happy they have somewhere to do business. Reese is gonna love this.
Can't see the Jawas anymore. Can't see them anymore. I wonder where we'll find them next.
Let's go, BD.
Here we go!
Come on, buddy. Got something, buddy? So what'd you find? Not a bad find.
You will regret that.
Let's go. Change the angle. Let's show this to Z. Let's get this data disk back to Z.
Mr. Tenderlot. This one's a rare catch indeed.
What is it?
The fabled farfish. Its tail is one riven with greed, soaked to the bone with tragedy. There are scant few far left on account of their succulent glands. But I do not intend to harvest the poor creature for its organs. I intend to bring it back to the saloon, where I might one day find a mate for it.
Playing matchmaker, huh? You found another fawfish before?
No. But fishing's about leaving the world better than you found it. A ripple's only as good as the stone you cast. Every tale, lad. Where did we end? Ah, yes. The monstrous Captain Wet, his crew and myself, fled aboard the pirate schooner of the filthy Zephyrs. Well, fast as the morning thaw, I could tell something was off. Wanyak, he wouldn't look me in the eye. Oh, and a dreadful stench was a-brewing his rotten beard. An augur of fate most ill. Wanyak took the helm, and with landing claws away, we flew to deep space, putting a few lifetimes between us and those pirates. We found ourselves afield of the Perlimian trade route. As soon as the captain took his hand off the yoke, he put it on his harpoon and gave me a look like a half-starved Tuca cat iron sprat. Scurvo, snarled the vile captain. You've gone as soft as an oyster's navel. If I couldn't trust you to spare a quorum with their blaster in your mouth, how could I trust you to skewer the great goober fish? Aye, my hesitance to pull the trigger had me undone. In spite of my most rabid pleas, the captain jettisoned wee Scurvo in an escape pod. The last thing I saw was his dread smile, crooked like a beeman's backbone. And so, my time aboard the Grapnel met a briny end. Sitting alone in a pod, in deep space, with nothing but a tank of old cod and gash. I'll tell you more later, lad. The despair. Ugh, the stench. It's enough to set my stomach a-churn to this very day.
I bet Z can get the data off this disk. I need to clear my mind.
Another holopuck. Let's check it out. Fair. Sounds like it was pretty crowded down here.
Something about you, something different.
Nothing I'm going to tell you.
Thank you.
only the Force. All set.
Enemy in aerial operation. Attack complete.
Firing on the target.
I'll never give in. Almost.
Combat. Okay. This is over. I'll shoot him. What should I do? I don't know. We're gonna take you out. No, don't let him run.
Roger,
roger.
Let me walk.
I was built for this.
I won't let you get away.
Come on. There it is.
Got you marked, I'm coming in.
You made it.
Anyone spot you?
Me? Not a chance. What are we dealing with? Any sign of the droid?
Some kind of service gantry.
Could be a way in.
It's the best option I can see. Only way to the Lucre Hulk is through the swamp.
For you, maybe. You want a ride, BD? When you're ready, make a move on that gantry. I'll be watching.
Copy that. That's one way not to get mud on your boots, huh? Now we just need to rescue Z. Hard to believe anything could live in this swamp. I guess our friend here makes it work. See that building, buddy? Guess someone does live here. Or did once.
Check this place out.
Absolutely not. My entire life is on that databank.